to the Domino Theory Television Program. My name is Sonny Francis, and I will be your host for this particular episode, as I am for each and every episode, if you will. Anyway, we're coming to you from Channel 29 and 76 in San Francisco, which is cable access, Comcast cable access TV. And we are under the auspices, I believe, of BAVAC, which is the Bay Area Video Coalition. And the Bay Area Video Coalition has quite a few programs, not only for young people, but for senior citizens like myself, and anybody in between that wants to be a producer of a show coming out of Channel 29, and you will be given the proper instructions as to how to do that. So I think it's a lot of fun. Keeps me out of trouble. I don't know what it'll do for you, but if you get a chance, you might want to go down and check it out. It's at 2727 Mariposa Street. That's at Mariposa and Bryant here in San Francisco. Now, this is a local thing, so it's aired locally. Also on the Wave, when I understand, WAVE 29 and 76, and also on AT&T channel 99 is what it is, channel 99. So if you get a chance, and you can also see us at www.sfdomino.com, which is our veterans and senior citizens who have come together from time to time to engage in the game of dominoes and also sound off on local events that we feel are necessary to talk about. I'd like to congratulate once again London Breed on her success as a supervisor once again, and we wish that she will continue in the same vein and help the people of the now defunct Fillmore community. We'd also like to thank the Board of Supervisors for passing a bill. I don't know if you know it or not, but the Sunnydale housing projects and the Carroll Hill area projects are all dilapidated pretty much, and they need quite a bit of work. So the Board of Supervisors finally got together and decided to do some repair and also some additional units, from what I understand, will be afforded to these two different projects. So, keep an eye on that. And also, I think a young man was shot in San Francisco Police Department. You know, I honestly get tired of telling you about the police department shooting people, and about people shooting other people, and all of this sort of stuff. But it's news, and I guess that's what people want to hear. So the young man in question, I saw a news bait. I only looked at it briefly, but I think that it's under investigation. I'm pretty sure it is right now. And they're trying to figure out what exactly happened in that event. Anyway, a couple of things that we need to talk to you about. The Northern California Big Six Domino Tournament coming up at the Hamilton Recreation Center, which will be February the 3rd, from 11 o'clock until 4 o'clock. It's a free event, and we invite the public to come out and join us. We're going to have some fun. We'll have surprises and prizes, along with the surprises. We'll also have some light refreshments, and we'll play some dominoes. So if you want to volunteer and contribute something to this cause, donations, we can't charge you to come in, because Rec and Park are donating space to us, which we appreciate very much. But if you want to give a donation, you're more than welcome to do that. And you do that by contacting myself at area code 415-724, pardon me, 8061. That's area code 415-724-8061. And I'll be happy to talk to you about it, and we can see what evolves from that. But we do need some volunteers, and we need some help. We hope that you come out and hope it's a nice day. And all of those hopes, we just throw up there and hope that they come down in the proper place. This is the Domino Terry Television program, by the way. And we have been on the air now for 5 or 6 years. Let's make it 6. And 6 seasons here at Channel 29 has been very enlightening for sure. We also have a Facebook page, isn't everybody? And we try very hard to entertain as well as educate people as to what is actually happening in the community. Not necessarily the local community, but also in the community at large, nationwide, and also statewide. It's kind of hard to get out and get news events on your own, but it's being done, and we managed to use the internet quite a bit to get our stories together. Anyway, be sure and come by, and you can also call Miss Renee Strong. She's the director at the Hamilton Recreation Center. She is a wonderful person, and you can talk to her at 415-292-2111, and she can give you some other information. Some of the sponsors are the Esquire Barbershop, the San Francisco Recreation and Park Department, the Association, I always want to say American, but it's Association of Midnight Basketball League. Mr. Larry Gray, we want to thank him very much for his assistance in helping us get this together. Also, New Bills up on Ms. Darrell Street in San Francisco also. We have been experiencing some really, really, really bad weather, but we need it because we haven't had rain in quite a while, and it astonishes me the fact that we have had a drought for 7 years, and we just had a storm, I think, about a couple of months, well, I guess 1 or 2 months ago it started. It's been off and on, but all of a sudden the drought is over. I heard that predicted. So I'll get back to this later on, but you need to be aware of what you watch on the internet, because it's not all true. I don't know if you knew that or not, but it's not all necessarily the truth. So be aware of stuff that you take off the internet, especially Facebook. A lot of stuff that goes up on Facebook is not really kosher. But anyway, we have some clips for you. I have an old Marvin Gaye clip, and I hope that you'll enjoy it. It's kind of fuzzy, but you get the message, and the message is what is going on. And we should all ask ourselves that question, what exactly is going on in the community, what's going on in the world, and what's going on around us. My name is Joe Francis. This is Domino Jerry, brought to you by the SFDOMINOCLUB. And you're listening to your viewing rather, Channel 29 and 76 in San Francisco, California. We'll be back.
Of you cry, brother, brother, brother. There's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Father, Father, we don't need to. You know me.
My boy was like, dog, are you running? No, actually, I'm standing still. Why would you? If your bath towel don't fit no more. Remember when you were small, you could put your bath towel, walk around the house with no hands? Now you big, you got to hold that mother right here. You ain't even got the whole towel, just the end. The thing be hanging out a little bit. Last clue, if you're a man with breasts. Anybody come to grips with this? I just found I had breasts 2 weeks ago. Me and my lady getting sexy. I looked up, she trying to suck mine. I'm like, look, you play too much. Putting up my bra self so I can go to work. It's true. Get big, your body change, man. Like, you know what I realized, too? It's like, first of all, women, you know, men have, like, body issues. But women, y'all different. Like, it's actually kind of cool to be a big guy. I see my man out there, you know, he is cool. Women like a man with some size. You feel safer. Am I right, ladies? You feel safer with a big dude. Let me tell y'all something. Ladies, this is different stuff. As a man, if you big, ain't no clothes you can wear to make you look smaller. You big, you just big. Women, on the other hand, they got all type of options. They sitting here tonight, they got their little outfits on looking cute. What you see on the outside. But up underneath there's another set of clothes. Finding that thing together. Now depending on how old she is, I'm gonna tell you what she got on. If she over 40, she may have a garment on called the Spank. The Spank is made of a space shuttle and aluminum sides. The Spank is incredible. The Spank will take a woman and bind everything up. I don't know, you ever see your lady get in the Spank? I came and caught my wife, like, she was late, she was sliding. That's why your lady always hot. That's why they always hot. You go, this shit kind of out. You got it hot in here. That's because you got on 12 outfits. Now, if she a little younger, she might have a garment on called a body mat. Body magic designed to smooth. Body magic smooth your lady out. My lady, she rocked that body magic sometimes. What it'll do, it take a displaced girth. So your lady got a little girthy section. It'll take some of the belly, push it up here. The rest of it, push it way down here. You be looking at your girl like, baby, you look good in there. My girl put that mug on the other day, she was looking good. And what happened, fellas, it brainwashed you, you don't even know. You looking at her like, oh, she's doing this, my girl, okay. Me and my lady, we went to the club, we had a good time, little date night, went out, had a ball, you know what I mean? Had a good time. We get home, I done forgot she got it on. She put that body magic out, look like somebody opened a life raft in the room. I said they didn't have anything for men, but body magic actually has a shirt for men. You know about this? Oh. Body magic got a shirt, you know, for men. It ain't no leotard, it's just a shirt. It don't button. with your shirt, you know what I'm saying? Let me tell you something, you wear that shirt, all of a sudden you can button your jacket again. So I went out and bought this shirt, felt good about myself. My back felt better, I was confident, I felt good. Only thing they don't tell you is you're not allowed to move in this shirt. I put this damn shirt on, went to the club, we getting it in. Next thing I know, this shirt riding up on my ass. I got a halter top on, trying to figure out why I look like Beyonce. This is the thing, ladies. And I'm looking at y'all tonight, I'm looking at how beautiful y'all is. This is the thing, fellas, you gotta know. No matter how beautiful a woman is, sometimes she second guess herself. Sometimes all women, no matter how beautiful they are, they worry if they good enough for us. Let me tell y'all something, ladies. Men ain't that deep. Whatever you think is wrong with you, it's a dude that loves that. Let me say that one more time. Whatever you think is messed up about you is a dude, that's all he likes. There's a woman in here right now with that keloid on her ear. The dude love that little earlobe. There's a woman in here right now, her baby toe just as big as her big toe. Foot look like an ace. She win all the kickball games though, she's nice. Every man likes something different, ladies, depending on his background, what he's been through in life. Like I'm looking at the room right now, I see we culturally diverse. Got my white friends out, my black friends out. Where my leg man at? Make noise, leg man. Stop, don't help me, don't. I've seen a couple of my white friends clap, black dude, stop. Cause black man don't give a damn about no leg. Ladies, you cannot have no leg. You can show up to the club, no leg. Gonna be one brother going, oh, yeah, we go. It's gonna be one brother trying to talk to him for tonight a little. Hey, where you going? Look, why don't we slide up out of here and do our thing? Yeah? We all like different things. But I think we come to a consensus over the last few years, black men, white men, Latin, everybody, we had a meeting. I don't know if y'all know this, ladies. We all like big booties. I said, we all like this book. I see you want, dude. I know what you like. This is the thing nowadays, fellas. Back in the day, a big booty, you would see it, and you was like, okay, that's all her. Not no more. They getting injections. They got some pants. They got some shorts. With a booty built in. You know what I mean? They call it the booty pop. Don't get me wrong, I don't have no problem with a person making themselves better, enhancing who they are. I don't have no problem with it. But if you're going to wear the booty pop, get the whole pack. Get the booty pop leg thigh combo. I was messing with this girl years ago. She had a big booty. Her booty was big, but she had weak legs. I said, take a note. Every time I take a note, she's like, that will let me tell jokes at the end of the day if I was shut up throughout the course of the day. So I always wanted to be a comedian. I've been in the Navy for 8 years, and I reached what I like to call a crossroads. At some point, you got to be willing to take some sort of leap of faith in your journey. So I was in the Navy, and the Navy provided a certain amount of security. You know, it's like living at mama house, but you got to work every day. You know, so 1998 came. I was at the point where I said, you know what? I got to either get out now or, you know, retire in the military. I said, you know what? I'm going to get out. And I told two people, I told my wife reluctantly said, I'm a roll. I got your back. I was like, you know what? Good, because I was going to leave your ass. I didn't say that. And I told my mother. My mother, my dog. You know what I'm saying? Anybody like really close to their parents, mother, father, my mother is my dog. I call my mother. She's my friend. She's the person that I go to, my go-to person in my life. I was like, Mom, I'm thinking about getting out. I'm getting out. I'm about to do this comedy full time. Are you losing your damn mind? You ain't that funny, first of all. I don't know who told you you can make a living doing. This lady read me the riot act over an hour. She gave me every possible reason why I shouldn't move forward. And I looked at her in her face and I said, Mama, I love you, but I gotta go forward. I got to go forward. Now, she would tell me weeks later that she had to put that type of pressure on me because if I was unable to take her pressure, I wasn't ready for real life. Right? So I packed up my family and I took what they called a leap of faith. Ah! What they don't tell you about the leap of faith is on the other side of that mug is real life. I got to LA and all of a sudden, I'm doing everything but cops. I mean, I manage an apartment building right in the heart of Inglewood, Market Street, the hood. I'll be showing the partners like, boom, look at that refrigerator. Hardest job I ever had. Because, one, people don't like to pay rent. I had literally a whole family crawl under my window. I seen hit the wife, the husband. I'm like, dog, it ain't that serious, man. I don't even really care. And then I had to do maintenance. You know what I'm saying? Where you had to go in people's apartment and fix stuff? You know, okay. Well, my wife did a lot of fixing, but it was one lady, she would have me come over all the time, and she would have a house coat on, right? And it wouldn't have no buttons or no string on it. It's just her holding it. All this ass exposed. Fix that faucet. I'm like, you know what? I got to get out of here. I looked up, and it was almost 2 years later. I had taken a leap of faith, but guess what? I'm still not really doing everything I came here to do. I work for a modeling agency. I don't know how the hell that happened. It ain't that funny, lady. And I found myself working at the VA, the Veterans Administration, and I had taken a temp job there, and when I took that job, man, I met a guy, Vietnam vet, double amputee, but he wouldn't let you feel sorry for him. You know what I'm saying? Every day we would have lunch and conversation. He would just share life with me. What's up, young buck? I see your boy doing your thing out there. Uh-huh. Let me tell you something, boy. You don't listen to nothing else, listen to this, okay? Get yourself a wife. Get yourself somebody you can share this life with. Go hand in hand. Somebody that love you and you love her. Okay, boy, you got that? And once you do that, get yourself a girlfriend because your wife ain't going to do nothing else. And so we was talking, one of them conversations, and he looked at me and said, young buck, let me ask you a question. I said, what are you doing here? I said, well, you know, I do data entry. I'm upstairs. He's like, you're a dumbass, ain't you? I said, well, I came here to be a comedian. I mean, I came here to, you know, maybe entertain the world. Maybe I get an opportunity to act one day. Maybe if I keep going and God bless me, I'll be in a real nice auditorium. Shooting a special. He said, what the hell you doing here? That day, I walked out of that office, and I ain't done nothing but stand-up comedy ever since, y'all. You got straight eyes. I can see them. I'm here to make such a shot. Hello, Grandma. But no, real
talk. Okay, one of the things I wanted to talk to you about before we had a break, was the City Job Fair, and that will be coming up Saturdays from 10 until 4. And the dates are January 21st, 28th, February the 4th, and February the 11th. Now, these events are sponsored by the Record Park Department, United States Post Office, SFO, which is the San Francisco Airport, Sheriff's Department, and also San Francisco Fire Department. The resources are job training and programming resources provided by the San Francisco Unified School District, City College of San Francisco, and more. Assistance with the city's job application system and job interest notices. You might want to go out and check it out and see what they have to offer. So the first one would be January 21st, which you are late for now because you won't see this broadcast in time. But anyway, it's at the Bay on Recreation Center, 1199 Mason Street. And we hope that you did turn out, even if you saw this late, because it's a worthwhile event. It's a city job fair. January 28th at Hamilton Recreation Center, 1900 Gary Boulevard, from 10 until 4. And February 4th at the Jolie Recreation Center, 1395 Mendel Street, out in the Bayview. February 11th. At Mission Recreation Center, 2450 Harrison Street. So those four events are job-orientated, the city's job fair, and it's all run by the San Francisco Rec and Park Department. So you might want to get out there and take a look at it and see what is happening. Before we close, we talked briefly about the internet and the sanctity of the internet. There are things that are put up on the internet that are very hurtful to people, things that are very untrue, and things that are worthwhile also. So when you go on the internet, you might want to check the facts about what you're reading and where they're coming from. You don't just go on and click on the thing, because that can cause viruses, of course, but it can also cause a lot of headaches. So you want to be sure, absolutely sure, that what you're rebroadcasting or what you're sharing with people is the truth. And the truth never hurt anybody. So be sure when you're on the internet that you are aware of what you're doing and what you're not doing and what you should be doing. This is a very interesting paper. It has a lot of stuff that's going on in the city. You know, there's a lot of free events in San Francisco at all times, and I guess there are stuff that people need to address at all times also. And this particular paper, I didn't get the title of it, but anyway, it has some very, very good articles. I see where it says Trump Survival Guide and How to Take Yourself from Big Brother. I saw somewhere that there is something like several million cameras out there watching us. And I don't know if you had the opportunity or not, but when I was younger, when I did a lot of reading, I saw a book entitled 1984 by George Orwell. And I don't know how many of you remember that or even have heard of it, but it predicted what you see going on right now. Right now we have government eavesdropping, we have people that are not safe. Well, nothing's safe anymore because there's always Big Brother. And I don't know what the solution is, but we need to be more cognizant of what we do and what we say and how we say it and where we do it. So we have a new administration coming in, and we'll see how big brotherish they are, of course. excuse me, Republicans as a whole And, you know, I hate to bunch people up in political groups as well as religious groups, because I think that there's only one group, period. That's the human race, and, you know, it's debatable. But when you start to compartmentalize people and put people in different places, that causes a lot of problems, because we're all a part of the human race. And you can say it again, and you can say it again, well, I'm African American, I'm Native American, I'm this, I'm that. But we're all here together, so we need to take a look at that a little bit further. This is the Domino Theory television program. My name is Gil Francis, and we come to you regularly, we hope, during 2017, every other Tuesday from 11 until 12. We haven't been during the holidays because we were in New Orleans and we had a wonderful time. I don't know if you've ever been to New Orleans, but if you haven't been, you should go. And I mean, you should go and you should go and come back. You should not go and stay for whatever reason. Just go and visit. It's a nice place to visit. Good food, good people, hospitality, but just don't get stuck. Trust me. I'll be back. This show is coming to you. I don't know when it's going to be broadcast, but whenever it's broadcast, I hope you enjoy it. We have some tips from Marvin Gaye, what's going on, and we also have some comedians that are working. And we're not making light of the situation, because things are very, very serious now. But I think that if we all start putting our hairs out, that wouldn't do very much good either. So we sort of went to the comedy side of the thing. And we want to inform you also of things coming up before we leave tonight, this broadcast. So take care. My name's Gil Francis.
Outside. And on my street, we played all the pool games.
play games like freeze tag. We took freeze tag a little too seriously. We didn't care where you got tagged at. You could have been in the middle of the street. You better stay frozen. I'm frozen. Somebody unfreeze me, please. It's a car coming, y'all. It's a Hummer. Hummers ain't even out yet.
Don't let the street lights go off. You start playing games like, how you go get it? What? Oh. I think the most worldwide game that everybody play, I don't care how old you are, how young you are, what nationality you are, everybody in this room play hide-go-seek. Everybody. Everybody. I can test your hide-go-seek skills. Y'all ready?
Put your feet in.
Any, mini, money, mo. Catch a tiger by his toe. If he holler, let him go. Any, mini, money, mo.
And what you doing around a person you don't like?
My mother told me to pick the best one, and you are not it. Because the Bible tells me so.
My name is DC Irvin. Y'all been a wonderful audience.
Try to be a part of it some kind of way. You know, don't judge me, you know. I just had a kid, y'all. Give it up for me. I just had a kid. But let me stop lying on television. I just got the paperwork back on.
Yeah, he's nine.
Yeah. No, for real, y'all. Don't judge me. These just jokes. I was a good daddy. I promise I am. I had to be a good daddy. I had no choice. My baby mama went to my church. It'd take 2 seconds for my grandma. Oh, Lord.
Help my grandson be a better dad than Jesus. He got the girl in the choir stand pregnant, Lord. Lord, I don't want to have to take down juvenile court. Everybody knows Social Security number 399. Shut up, child, grandma.
Grandma got me robbed and on child support. That's great, man. But yeah, man, you gotta be a good dad, man. Be there for your kids, man. Because I'm gonna tell you, man, as men, there's just certain things that us as men have to be there to teach our sons. You know what I mean? Women can't do everything. They can't teach them everything that we know. Sometimes they need to ask the man, and you need to be there. You know what I'm saying? For real talk, you need to be there because that question gonna come that only you can answer. Now, prime example. My son had a question he needed to answer. He wanted to know what his penis was. Yeah, he's a little confused. He's wiggling around, squirting out water. Pretty sure some questions arose. So he gonna ask my baby mom. Now I guess she panicked because the only thing that she can think to tell him is, oh son, that's your little bug. I don't know why that came to her head, but that's the only thing that popped up. That's your little bug, son. Now, I didn't know this. He finally started coming over to my house, right? Spending the night, right? We finna take a shower one time, because you know you gotta watch the boys take a shower, because they'll go in the shower and come out just as stinky as they was when they went in there. So I'm in the shower, you know what I'm saying? You know, making sure you do everything right. All of a sudden, my son just gonna bust out the shower, you know. Man, that's a big old bug. You know, I had some roaches, though. I'm like, man, what the fuck? I wish I knew what was about to happen, because I could have done something. It was too late. The next thing messed him up for life. Seemed like the whole world went in slow motion, but I was like, right where, son, where the bug at? He was like, right
I like it when you hit me though. I like it. your breath smelling like this? You smell that? That's you, guys. Hey, that's you, y'all.
Baby.
It's all I got, and you said you wouldn't say that in front of nobody else.
I said I wouldn't tell about Cialis, but why after? I'm gonna tell everybody.
That's all I got. It's real, my pill right here. It's all I got.
Well, take them, man. Why you gonna take them? It's all the liquor.
Thank you.
enjoyed the show. We have certainly enjoyed bringing it to you. I met a gentleman on a plane back from New Orleans, and he gave me a book. His name was Dan, and he gave me a book called The Ministry of Healing. And this is quite a book. Also, a book called Prophets and Prophecies. And I'm in the process of reading it also. And I want to thank Dan very much for sharing that with me. I'll get to you as soon as possible. We have covered quite a few things this program, and we have hopefully enlightened you as to some of the things that need to be done and should be done around the area being local San Francisco. It's just too bad that these people want to take a lot of people off of health care. I just wonder, you know, is it any different from the Holocaust when you take people that are sick and you just throw them out? You know, what is the difference? We have quite a bit of work to do for sure, and I hope that we get busy and start doing it. I want to recall your attention to one of the things that we talked about earlier was City Job Fair, Saturday, 10 until 4, January 21st, January 28th, February 4th, and February the 11th. And it will be held at the Bay and Recreation Center, 1199 Mason Street in San Francisco, 1900 Gary Boulevard and Hamilton Recreation Center on January 28th, Jolie Recreation Center, 1395 Mendel Street, and February 11, 2017 at the Mission Recreation Center, 2450 Harrison Street. So you want to be sure and drop by there and see if you can get some information about some jobs. Also, you can call 415-831-2726. That's 415-831-2726 and get some further information. I talked to you about the Domino tournament that's coming up on the 3rd of February at the Hamilton Recreation Center. It's free, and we encourage you to come. We're going to have surprises and surprises. Veterans, seniors, and whoever else that knows how to play dominoes is welcome to play. But you have to be able to see. That's one of the criteria. So if you can see and you can count, you're in. So be sure to be there at 11 o'clock because we start promptly at 11 o'clock and we hope that we'll get a decent turnout. We'll need a whole, like, 1,000 people to come, but we do need, you know, some people. So put that on your calendar and let's see what happens. This article about how to learn to spot fake news on the internet and other places, also not just the internet, but fake news comes also on the major news outlets also, and I have been witness to that. You have also a lot of stuff that is said is said off the cuff and not really thought about, and this is one of the most detrimental things that God gave us, and if we don't use it properly, we can do a lot of damage. Doing more damage, I think, than an AK-47 or a bomb, for that matter. But this is a very powerful, very, very powerful tool, your mouth. So watch what you say and who you say it to and how you say it, and you'll be okay. We want to invite you back to see us again. We're here on Tuesdays, hopefully from 11 to 12. And pardon me, coming up, we'll have a Black History Show at the end of the month here live broadcast. And we're going to have some producers and some people from the community come in as we did last year. And we're going to put it all together and see what we come up with. History Month celebration coming up. And we here on the Domino Show will be showing you some of them from our archive that we have, and we hope that you enjoy it also. Thank you very much for tuning in. This has been a pleasure being with you, and I hope that you will contact us at sfdominoclub@gmail.com. And let's know what you think about the program, even if it's there. So we encourage you to do so. And also, if you want to do a program here, can't do anything, but you can use Spotify. This is cable access TV. So we don't adhere to a lot of rules, but we adhere to rules, give respect, and try to give a quality program. So with that said, I will shut up and get out of here. My name is Joe Francis. This is called the Domino Theory, produced by the SF Domino Club. And we thank you very much. Come back and see us again. We love you. And there's plenty you can do about it. Thank you.